Hi, I'm Benno Schmidt. Thanks so much for joining us for tonight's dLife. Because guess what? We at dLife have been listening to you. You've told us through the dLife mail, Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter what you want to know more about. So for the next several weeks, we'll have new segments on pre-diabetes, what it is and what it means to you, and technology, how it can help and simplify your life. Plus, we'll visit my favorite, Jim Turner, for his unique, inspired, and very humorous takes on what it's like to live with diabetes. So, let's get started.
Hi, I'm Susan Weiner, registered dietitian and certified diabetes educator, and this is Leslie Josel. Leslie is a certified professional organizer and the owner of Order Out of Chaos, and together, Leslie and I are co-authoring a book called The Complete Diabetes Organizer, Your Guide to a Less Stressful and More Manageable Diabetes Life. It's coming out this fall.
Today we're going to share with you some great tips and tools for organizing and setting up your healthy refrigerator. So Susan, let's get started. So there's three rules of thumb to getting organized for your refrigerator. Easy breezy. First one is we categorize our food. The second rule of thumb is to maximize our storage space. We know that the refrigerator has a lot of black holes. And the third rule of thumb is to label.
So why don't we start with the condiments?
Okay, that's great. So I see a few salad dressings and mayonnaise and stuff like that.
Right, so let's put this over here.
So here's the interesting thing about categorizing. We always say think like a library.
Oh.
Right? Because it's like think children's section, travel guides. Most people, when they put things away in the fridge, they end up doing it by size, but if you do it by category, right. You know what you have.
Oh, that's a great suggestion.
Right? And then you can find what you need mm-hmm. when you need it.
Right.
Okay. So, fruits and vegetables, mm-hmm. we got those going on. Avocados, I love them.
Okay.
But I don't know, do they go in the fridge? Do they go on the counter? What do we do?
Okay, that's a great question. Avocados. These are delicious ones that we got today at the supermarket, and I actually like to keep the avocados out for a day or two because they just ripen beautifully a few days after you're home.
So you don't put them in like a paper bag?
You can put them in a paper bag if you need them like the next day.
Okay.
But I prefer to keep them in a bowl, and they're so pretty. Look at these.
I know.
They're fantastic.
It's like art. I love it.
It is.
All right, so what I also did before we got started is I grabbed our dairy bin mm-hmm. out of the refrigerator just to start grouping things into it. And here's what I like. Number one, I love labeling the bins because it's not just about knowing where everything is in the fridge. It's also about putting things away. So I have young kids, and I know when I ask them to put something away, they're more likely to just take it and put it wherever they find room.
That.
Don't
That's
you love
great.
That? This way, there's no questions. We're not having a conversation. This
it
is
says
going,
dairy.
It says dairy. You can see it. Don't tell me you can't find room.
I'm
so
gonna
that's
put
great.
Cheeses in there as well.
Okay.
And the cheeses, of course, are a very healthy snack.
Okay.
And would you please grab that butter and put
sure.
this in as well?
Okay. And I like bins like this. I'm a big clear girl. I think if it's clear, you're gonna see it, you're
yes.
gonna know what's in it. But bins can get expensive. So a great tip is to go to the dollar store. They are a treasure trove for bins, baskets, even trays. It doesn't have to look like this. Anything that is going to corral your items.
Put them together.
Put them together, you can use.
Before we get any further into the organizing aspect, I'm sure everybody at home has wondered how you store your fruits and your vegetables when you bring them home from the supermarket, right? Haven't you?
Oh,
when you bring them home?
All the time. I don't know what goes in the fridge, what goes on the counter.
Exactly. There's usually a couple of bins that people have in the refrigerator. If you have room, keep your vegetables in a separate bin and your fruits in a separate bin. Apples should be put on your counter. right?
Okay.
So you put all the apples, no matter what kind they are, Rome, Delicious, apples, Macintosh, all different kinds of apples, keep them in here. And don't wash them until you're ready to use them.
So let's talk a little bit about labeling.
Okay.
Can we do that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I think it's a great idea to keep your labels right by where you put your groceries.
So that it's handy. Look at the great colors that you have there too.
I know, well, you know what? It should be happy. It should be fun.
This is great.
Is that great?
Yes.
Okay, so I brought two different things to show you. One is easy breezy again. You know, I'm a believer of organized enough. Sharpie, Post-it, and you're done.
Oh, wow, great.
So, but I like the fun colors. You can even color code if that's what you're into. So if you're putting even in the fridge some very diabetes specific foods, mm-hmm. you might want to take a colored Post-it and use that so everyone in the house knows pink, diabetes food, mm-hmm. off limits to me, but for, you know, whoever in the mm-hmm. house has the mm-hmm. diabetes. But the other fun thing is this is tape. But now they make
that's
it in
tape.
All.
This How do you like that?
Scotch tape.
That's great.
All different colors. So again, you can do it, color code your groceries, or again, if you want to label anything diabetes specific. So let's get finished up and then we can get everything in the fridge.
Absolutely, that sounds great.
It's like, let's make a deal.
It is.
Right?
Ready?
Okay,
one,
here
two,
we go.
Three.
Door number one.
Here we are.
Looks great, doesn't it?
Our organized refrigerator.
Yeah, this is great.
Before we even get started on anything to do with the food and how we organized everything, I want to point out something very important. For those people taking insulin, it's very important to keep it in its own special organized place in the refrigerator where you can clearly see the labels and the expiration date.
You're right, front and center.
Absolutely, front and center.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So, do you know what that is, Susan?
I see all the condiments on it. What is it?
This is a Lazy Susan. But what's great about a Lazy Susan is it rotates. So those hard to reach items in the back of the fridge can easily come to the front. No waste, no overspending, perfect.
Right here we have a bin labeled free snack which has calorie-free, carb-free items in it, such as diet soda or sugar-free Jell-O.
So I have a question for you, Susan. Mm-hmm. I bring home meat from the supermarket. Right. I never know where it should go in the fridge. Can you tell me a little bit about what's the best place it should go?
Absolutely. Meat or poultry always goes, that's uncooked, that you bring right home from the supermarket, on your lowest shelf, by itself, no cross-contamination.
Love it. Okay, and a bin is great too, because it's clear, again, you can see through mm-hmm. it, so you exactly know what it is that you brought home, so you don't forget about it.
Great.
So, if you notice, and I always like to say, black holes in the fridge, we all know that we can never really reach what's behind. So all of these bins go all the way to the back of the fridge, so that all of these items that would be put away in the back that you'd never find again are easily seen. You take them out and then easily put back. So we're maximizing every little bit of space in our fridge today.
If you see over here, we have some milk and a container of egg whites, and behind it, the diet soda.
And what I love that we did also is not everything has to go in a bin. So those items that are gonna go directly on the shelf, put the bigger ones in the back. So even though we have the milk in front, we can see the diet soda peeking out. So again, we know what we have.
And right here, I have last night's leftover chicken.
Yum.
Clearly in a bin that we can see it. So that's right there. And also we like to have things on the door that don't have to stay quite as cold because that's the warmest part of the refrigerator. So right here we keep the orange juice. And in these two drawers, we have one drawer with fruits and one drawer with vegetables. We don't like to keep them in the same drawer if we can help it because some of the vegetables tend to emit gases that can contaminate the way that the fruit tastes.
See, I didn't know that.
You can learn a lot cooking with me.
I absolutely am.
Absolutely.
I didn't know that.
So
that's great.
So let's close the refrigerator and keep the temperature down. That was so much fun. And I learned so much.
Oh, I learned so much too. This was great, right?
It was great. I hope that you learned a lot today too. If you want more tips on how to organize your diabetes refrigerator, please check out dlife.com/organize. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Hi, I'm Mr. Divabedic, and tonight I'm bringing dLife to the dinner table. I'm at the home of the Vies family, and we're going to play my newest food game, Serve, Taste, or Trash. So you think that this family could decide on what they would like to serve, what they would like to taste, and what they would like to trash?
Absolutely.
Okay, so this is how we play the game. I have three food items, which I love. I'm nuts for nuts. I have almonds, I have peanuts, and I have walnuts. You have to tell me which one you would serve to each other, which one you would taste, a little nibbler. We gotta be careful with the portion control, and which one you would trash. Nicholas, you're first. Which one are you gonna serve?
Probably the almonds.
I would probably also serve the almonds.
Walnuts.
I'd probably taste the peanuts.
You taste the peanuts?
Yes.
How about you, Missy?
The almonds.
Almonds.
And which one are you gonna trash, Nicholas?
Oh, walnuts.
Walnuts? Which one are you trashing?
I love them all. Do I have to pick one to trash?
I think you're trashing the peanuts.
I think I'll trash the peanuts.
Are you trashing the peanuts?
Yes, trashing the peanuts.
Well, guess what? There's good news here, because if you just thought the only way to have a peanut was with peanut butter, you're wrong, because Chef Michel Nischan has got an incredible recipe called beef satay that takes this simple peanut and dresses it up for dinner.
Hi, I'm Chef Michel Nischan. Welcome to the dLife Kitchen. What we're making today is based on an authentic dish from Southeast Asia, satay, very simply marinated meat grilled on skewers and served with various dipping sauces or seasonings, almost always nice and spicy. Now, the most popular is probably spicy peanut sauce, and that's what we're gonna make today. Now, what I love to do is start with beef round because it's inexpensive, and when you can, what I would like you to do is spend a little more money and get grass-fed beef. So what I'm doing is taking this round, which is great because it's pretty much ready to go right from the grocery store, cutting it into strips just like this. And now I'm gonna take a good old Ziploc bag and we're gonna pop the meat into the bag and then take a little bit of minced ginger. We got some garlic and either some homemade beef stock, which is what I prefer, or you can use low sodium beef broth. There are a lot of really great natural and organic products that you can get in the grocery store. And then some low sodium soy sauce. Put it in the Ziploc bag. Now, you don't want to let this go any more than 2 hours. Now we're going to come over and pop this in the fridge. And here we have some meat that's already been marinated. And here you can see that it's just getting a little bit off pink. This is perfect. This is ready to go. Now I have some nice bamboo skewers here, and basically what I did with the skewers is I soaked them overnight in water. You want to soak them overnight in water because if you don't do that, they're going to burn under the broiler. And here I think I have some that are pre-done. And now we're going to pop this under a hot broiler and really just 5 to 7 minutes, turning them once, and they should be delicious. There we go. Now, spicy peanut sauce really couldn't be any easier. We have peanut butter, which is awesome. Now, nuts and nut butter long have been known to be beneficial for people with a variety of health conditions, including diabetes. It's got good fats, really great plant nutrients, lots of fiber, really good stuff. Now, you can see this is nice and runny, and it just smells wonderful. We have a little bit of fresh lime juice, some great honey, and I love to use local honey. And then we have a little bit of Asian chili paste, which is dynamite, very delicious. So chili paste has capsaicin, really great source of vitamin C, and nice and caliente, spicy, picante, very delicious. Some red pepper flake, and now some fresh chopped cilantro. Remember that marinade in the bag? What I did was put it in a pot and brought it to a simmer on the stove to pasteurize it and also to make it warm. So I have a little bit of the marinade in here. Now, all of these ingredients have the compounds and phytochemicals that are really great for helping fight and prevent a variety of disease, and they just happen to be delicious as well. Now, I have a feeling that these skewers are perfectly cooked. Yeah, look at that. This smells amazing. Now, you want to be a little careful because the skewers can be a little bit hot, fresh out of the broiler like this. Little bit of this fresh cilantro right over the top, and there you have it. Now you can find this recipe and thousands more at dlife.com/recipebox. After giving this recipe a little bit of spin, take it for a test drive, come back to the website, give it a review for us.
My name is Michel Nischan, and thanks for joining us today in the dLife Kitchen.
Hi, I'm Joy Pape, certified diabetes educator, here to answer the dLife mail. A friend on Facebook asked, why is my blood sugar so high after I have a low? That's not unusual. Think about it. When your blood sugar's low, many times you are so hungry you want to eat the house. And you're not thinking so straight. And years ago, they taught us to drink these big glasses of juice and put sugar in it, and some people are still doing that. So one reason it could be so high after being so low is because of taking in too many carbohydrates, and it catches up with you later. Another reason may be that you're not following the rule of 15. For example, you're taking a carbohydrate that's not fast acting. So it hasn't acted quick, and you keep eating and eating and eating, and finally those carbs catch up with you later and your blood sugar is too high. This happens a lot of times with my patients who like to have chocolate to treat their blood sugars or other types of sweets that have fats in them. It's not gonna work right away, but it sure works later for a high blood sugar. Another reason is your body responds by putting off certain hormones that raises blood sugar. So that, with the overtreatment or even that alone, can cause your blood sugar to be too high. Some people have gastric neuropathy. And when you have gastric neuropathy, it is hard to tell when your food is going to be digested. So it may be that you've treated for a low, but your food has slow emptying or slow digesting, and it's not until much later the treatment shows up. And again, you might have overtreated because you were trying to get your blood sugar up. This is Joy Pape, certified diabetes educator with dLifeTV.com.
One of the coolest things about dLife is meeting extraordinary people and introducing them to viewers. People like my dad, who is also named Benno. He loves dLife and visits all the time. The subject of this, Where Are They Now?, is one of my dad's favorites. Robert has been teaching others to fly and thought that his dream might be over when he got diabetes, but not at all. He was really just taking off. And Robert Stambo Stambofsky is still at it, still flying, still teaching others how to fly, still teaching pilots who have their wings how to get better, how to improve to the next class of aircraft, and yes, this sounds ominous, but it's true, Robert is still glad to just still be here. You may remember the shock this lifelong Marine, airshow performer, aeronautics teacher, and flight instructor felt when he was first diagnosed with type 2 diabetes back in 2007. Stambo shared those scary first moments with dLife when we originally featured him several years ago.
I was devastated. I wasn't sure what to expect, and of course going through my mind is, well, I'm not going to be able to fly again. And I thought, God, what am I going to do? I'm going to have to learn to sail, macrame. And my poor wife, you know, she's, I'm sure, going through her mind, she was saying, what am I going to do with this guy if he can't fly an airplane? I was very, very frightened.
But it didn't ground him. Instead, Robert ate better, exercise, something he still does on a daily basis, and the results show. After tipping the scales at 230 pounds, Robert is down to 212 and hopes to see a trim 195. Stambo goes to the gym, even has a personal trainer. And oh yeah, he's flying. His annual physical came back perfect, and his A1C is normal or better. And he just turned 69. His only med is Januvia, and Stambo's stayed off insulin and never had an A1C even approach 9. Both career enders for commercial pilots. He calls his original dLife appearance his 15 seconds of fame and says fellow pilots wrote, called, and emailed with questions about diabetes and flying. His vision is now perfect after eye surgery, and Stambo wants to continue flying his beloved warbird at air shows and recently launched a 4-day flight seminar he'll take on the road. Well done, Robert. You aimed high and made it. Well, that's it for this edition of Where Are They Now? Thanks so much for joining me. That was an uplifting one, right? It's a little corny, but also true. I'm Benno Schmidt. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you soon. Thanks so much for joining us for tonight's dLife TV. And we're serious when we say we want to hear from you. What are you interested in? What do you want to know more about? Send us your ideas right below, or contact us with Facebook or Twitter. And for all of you film buffs, there's a chance your video could actually appear right here on dLife. That's it for tonight's show. I'm Benno Schmidt. We'll see you next Sunday.